So today, I just want to walk you through the basics of Filmora. There's 1,000 features in Filmora. There's so many different things that you can do with this editing software. But I'm going to show you the basics of how just to open up the program, get some footage brought into it, cut your footage up, and be able to export your footage to a file and save it. So the first thing you'll see is options on the opening screen. Now there's a drop-down menu for the aspect ratio. If you don't know what these mean, it's basically different aspects for different platforms. For example, YouTube uses a 16:9 widescreen. Think of that as holding your phone sideways, the same way you would view something on a big screen TV. And something like portrait 9:16 would be holding your phone upright. And platforms like IGTV, Instagram television, use 9:16. We're gonna go today with your standard 16:9 widescreen format as if we're gonna make a YouTube video. And we're gonna open up the full feature mode. So the first thing you're gonna see is there's 3 main sections to Filmora. And in the upper left, this is your import window. This is where you click to bring files in that you're gonna work with. That can be video files, image files, audio files. Over to the right is going to be your preview screen. So anything that you bring in, you're going to be able to preview over to the right in control. If it's a video clip, you can play it and watch it. And down below is your timeline. This is where all the action happens. And that's broken up into several sections. It's got an upper section that's going to have where your video lays. There's a second section below it that they call picture in picture, which is your overlays. If you're going to lay a second picture over the original video picture. They have a text area, so if you do any text over your images, that will all show up in this bar. Now below that are 2 audio tracks, and you can add more tracks. Below this, you'll see this add new track. If you needed more, you can adjust that and add text tracks and add music tracks. But today we're gonna go really simple and just work with 1 track of video footage and cut that down and edit it. So the first thing we're gonna do is let's find ourselves a piece of video footage. When you have no other footage already imported, you'll see this green import media files here, and you can click on that to find some video footage. I click on it and it imports it right into this window. Now notice that original green import screen is now gone. That's just there only when you first open up and there's no footage imported. But if you look right above where I just imported that piece of video is the word import with a drop-down menu. If you click on that and put import media files, it'll open up a window to import more video files just like the original icon did. But for right now, let's work with this 1 file. So you can see once I brought that in, it opened it up in the preview window. And if I actually wanted to watch that video clip, I could hit the play button. And this allows me to preview that particular piece of footage. The first thing we want to do if we want to edit this footage is we have to bring it into our timeline. So what you want to do is reach up, left click and hold, and drag that down into the top bar. That is your video track. Release and it'll drop it right here. You can see the footage is now in the timeline. It's actually longer than fits in this particular window. There's a few ways we can move through this and adjust our viewing aspects. If you look below this green line, you can scroll and scrub through this whole track to get to different points in this video. You can also do the same thing on this line up in the preview window up here. If you hold that dot, that will scroll your cursor through and you'll be able to reach different points in the video. You can change the zoom of the view over here on the right with this bar. I tend to grab it and slide it. That will condense it and shrink it, or you can expand it to zoom way in when you have to do very fine tuning edits. There's a plus and a minus sign to the left and right that do small adjustments that you can use as well. I tend to use this slider bar. For me, it's the easiest way to do it. I just grab it and slide it. There's a neat little button right here that if you hover over it, you'll see that it says zoom to fit timeline. And if you click that button, it'll take all the information in your project and make it fit in the one window. That's kind of a cool feature. If you just need to find some things and your project is really long, you can click that. It puts everything right in front of you, and then you can grab the timeline bar and slide it to that portion where you need to be, and then you can zoom in because the zoom bar, it'll always zoom based on that tracking bar. Think of that as the playhead. The first thing that we want to do when we bring a new piece of footage in is over here. See this little arrow? It is green. That is the render feature. And if you don't know what rendering is, rendering is basically the software calculating what it needs to do to be able to produce a final product. And when you bring a lot of raw footage in and you add effects, you're asking the software to do a lot of different things. If you hit the render button, it'll allow for a smooth playback as you're working on your project. What I'll show you next is how to cut these files up. We can preview up in the window the spots that we need to use. If this is the spot I want to edit, there's a couple of ways to do this. Now, the most simple way is, do you see this pair of scissors right on the playhead? If I click that, it will slice this footage into two pieces, split right there. Another way to do this is if you come over just above the timeline, right here, there's a set of scissors. You can also click there, and you'll also create a split. If you click on these sections, you'll see that they highlight and turn blue. That means that they're active sections that we can work on. Say I wanted to get rid of this section, I can right click and I'll get a drop down menu and it'll say delete at the bottom. And I can say perfect, click, gone. If I ever make a mistake and accidentally delete something, all I need to do is come up here to the upper left hand corner where it says edit, click on the edit and click undo. And it'll bring that back, and it'll go back several steps. So if you ever make a mistake, don't panic. You can undo what you just did and you can recover that footage. So now you know how to import, you know how to delete, and you know how to trim pieces. So if you have several pieces that you have cut out, I'll just cut some random sections in here. Let's say that's the portion that I need to lose. If I want to remove this, it's now highlighted. I right click on it, I hit delete, and it has removed that section and it has brought the other two sections after it right up tight so that there's no gap left inside of the video. I can do that anywhere in the timeline. Once you have those clips together, you want to export this and save it as a complete project. If you go to the upper left and click on File, but from the drop-down menu, you want to click on Save Project As. All you do is put that in and hit save, and it has now saved everything we've done here. So if you're not going to export it at the moment, you're going to come back and work some more. Now it's all saved. You could close Filmora and come back to it whenever you want. But if you're done and you want to export it, you want to come over here. There's an export button, and it's going to open up a window and ask you a few questions. There's a lot of different options we'll get into later on, but for right now, we're going to just export and save our video file onto our computer. Now there's different formats you can use, MP4, AVI, there's a bunch. It depends on the application. YouTube recommends that you upload in an MP4 format. You don't have to, but it's the most widely used upload format. So we'll go with MP4, and then we want to come over here to the settings. And you click on the settings, it's going to give you these two sections. The upper section is just basically going to talk about how you want the video portion of it saved. And the lower section is going to talk about how you want the audio portion saved. So we like all of this, so we're at the best quality right now anyway. Perfect. Let's hit OK. Up here, we can label our project. So let's label it test project, and then we can determine where we want it saved on our computer. For right now, I'm going to say desktop. Nice and easy. And we just hit export. And there it is. Mission complete. Let's go over to the desktop, and there we have it right there. Test project. All exported and edited. Kind of cool. So that's the most simple walkthrough of Filmora. Just how to bring your footage in, how to quickly edit it, and how to save your project and export your project. Those are the basic things you'll need to do to start combining and editing video.